public on ordinance number 1430 only.
Second.
Offered by Councilman Zemchansky, seconded by Councilman Manna. All in favor?
Aye.
At this time, if anyone would like to speak publicly on ordinance number 1430, I ask that you come forward and state your name and address for the record. Seeing and hearing no, can I have a motion to close?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Hold on, guys. One second, guys. Can I have a motion to adopt the second reading?
So moved.
Offered by Councilman Stiliano, seconded by Councilman Freeman. Roll call vote, please.
Councilmembers Carrick?
Yes.
Casper?
Yes.
Freeman?
Yes.
Mann?
Yes.
Stiliano?
Yep.
Zemchansky?
Yes.
Thank you. Ordinance number 1431, second reading, a bond ordinance providing for the Department of Public Works garage site improvements in and by the Borough of Dumont and the County of Bergen in the state of New Jersey, appropriating $240,000 thereof and authorizing the issuance of $228,000 in bonds or notes of the borough to finance part of the cost thereof. Motion to waive formal reading.
So moved.
Offered by Stiliano.
Second.
Seconded by Manna. All in favor?
Aye.
Discussion from the governing body at this time. Hearing and seeing none, can I have a motion to open up to the public on the second reading of ordinance number 1431?
Second.
Offered by Councilman Carrick, seconded by Councilman Freeman. All in favor?
Aye.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to address ordinance number 1431, I ask you to step forward and state your name and address for the record. Seeing and hearing no, the motion to close.
So moved.
Offered by Councilman Stiliano, seconded by Councilman Manna. All in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed, can I have a motion to adopt on second reading?
So moved.
Offered by Councilman Carrick.
Second.
Seconded by Councilwoman Zemchansky. Roll call vote, please.
Councilmembers Carrick?
Yes.
Casper?
Yes.
Freeman?
Yes.
Manna?
Yes.
Stiliano?
Yes.
Zemchansky?
Yes.
Liz, thank you. Have a good night. Ordinance number 1432, second reading, a bond ordinance providing for the phase three of various storm sewer improvements in and by the Borough of Dumont and the County of Bergen, State of New Jersey, appropriating $230,000 thereof and authorizing the issuance of $218,500 in bonds or notes of the borough to finance part of the cost thereof. Motion to waive?
So moved.
Offered by Councilman Stiliano?
Second.
Seconded by Councilman Zemchansky. Kenny, are you going to be able to pass it?
Yeah.
Discussion from the council?
Real quick, Mr. Mayor, or John, whoever wants to, could one of you just explain this ordinance for the public so that they understand that it's to pay for work that has already been done?
Sure. Yeah, this ordinance underwrites the work that had been performed in anticipation of the phase three storm sewer project in the White Beaches section. As many of you may have recalled, phase one of the New Jersey Environmental Infrastructure Trust Program consisted of the area around New Milford Avenue, Johnson, Oak, and Manhattan Terrace. Phase two of the Environmental Infrastructure Trust Program contains and deals with the stabilization and the dredging of the Hirschfield Brook, which runs from Roostereto Avenues all the way down to Quackenbush Avenue, so approximately about half the town. The borough, based on recommendations from multiple engineering and also the Department of Environmental Protection, was looking at beginning a phase three program, which would effectuate the White Beaches section, particularly Cypress, thank you, White Beaches, over to Barber Road. That project had begun, the design work had been completed. We will have our permits on hand, so that way when the available financing becomes apparent, we will then have that on the shelf ready to go. So what we need to do is just pay for the design and the permitting cost.
Thank you.
We had a motion to waive formal reading from Councilman Stiliano, seconded by Councilwoman Zemchansky. All in favor?
Aye.
Any discussion from the council? I have a motion to open up to the public.
So moved.
Second. Offered by Councilman Stiliano, seconded by Councilman Freeman. All in favor?
Aye.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to address ordinance number 1432, I ask that you step forward and state your name and address for the record. Mr. Chen.
Hi, Chen. My name is Keith Wood. Mr. Mayor, I have a question. The question regarding this ordinance is that, is it normal and customary to have work done in 1 year, but get it paid for in another year? Where you get the financing secured.
I'm sure as you're familiar with New Jersey Environmental Infrastructure Trust Program administered by the state of New Jersey and the Department of Environmental Protection, that a municipality must front run all projects to secure the financing. So in order to qualify and be included in the bond that is adopted by the legislature, the municipality must initiate the work, complete the work, pay for the work, while DEP is watching over your shoulder, and until that is done and submitted to DEP, they will not even consider the application. Now, we have the permits in hand. The work has been completed. We started this program mid-year, about a year ago. We are now paying for it. We had hoped to be included in the October 2011 financing note issued by the state of New Jersey. We decided not to do that because of the interest payments that would be resulting in a tax increase. So to answer your question, yes.
So it's normal and
yes.
Customary too?
Yes. As you're not familiar with the EIT project, since we are about to begin our phase two, I strongly suggest that you visit their website, through the DEP website. And it's a great program that enables municipalities such as the Borough of Dumont to address chronic storm sewer problems that...
I have it through the documentation, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, great. Then I'm sure you'll laud the program as much as I do.
Somehow.
Right. Thank you. Can I have a motion to close? Offered by Councilman Manna, second by Councilman Freeman. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion to adopt on second reading.
So moved.
Offered by Councilman Manna, second by Councilman Freeman. Roll call vote, please.
Councilmember Scarrett?
Yes.
Casper?
Yes.
Freeman?
Yes.
Madden?
Yes.
Siliani?
Yes.
Demichelis?
Yes.
Thank you. And can I have a motion to open it to the public for general comment?
So moved.
Second. Offered by Councilman Siliani. Second by Councilman Freeman. All in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to address the governing body, I encourage you to do so. If you could just state your name and address for the record.
Kevin Price, 5 minutes Price.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
How are you today, Mr. Price?
Okay. The question I have is, several weeks ago, we suddenly had new parking restrictions on Essex Place that only affected the homes near Washington Avenue. The whole over half of the street has no parking restrictions. I received a parking ticket. I've been there for 8 years. I didn't know there was a new restriction. The dentist on the corner has been there for 40 years. He got a ticket. And all of a sudden, we have these restrictions. We can't park between 9 and 11 a.m. Monday to Friday. We don't know why.
I'm going to be honest with you. I can't answer that question. I don't know why either.
I have to find downstairs at the police department, and they told me to come to this meeting.
I wish they would have told you. You just would have called us. They would have let me...
I think it's to prevent commuter parking on the street.
It's from
9 a.m. to 11, which
wouldn't,
I guess it would have said, wouldn't make sense.
Usually it's from 6 to 9, commuter parking. Let me get your phone number in your contact. I'll have to find out for you, sir. I just don't know. It's actually kind of random, odd.
There's a problem if we have people who live in the neighborhood.
Right.
If it's the block of people from parking there, now we can't park there. What has happened now is that we have to park cars on the lawn,
right,
which kind of looks like a trailer park situation now.
Right.
And, you know.
Yeah, I apologize for the inconvenience in that I can't answer tonight. If you could just give your phone number to Sue,
okay. We
will be back to you tomorrow morning with some type of an answer and, if possible, correct the situation.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
Anyone else with this?
Mr. Chen. Thank you, Mr. Chris.
Hi, Chen, 92 Grove. Mr. Mayor, is the comments on the budget, is that closed?
You can, it has been moved, but you feel free to comment on it in the public record.
Sure. My first comment is about the revenue item for parking meters. Currently, that is blank. I was hoping that there might be an idea floated as to get some parking revenues. Right now, the only parking revenues I understand is the resident parking in the commuter lot. Are there any plans to expand that for either non-residents or visitors?
I'm not going to speak for other members of the governing body, and I'm going to encourage them to weigh in. But the fee schedule that we have adopted dramatically increased the original fee schedule several years ago. That fee schedule, I think, was adopted 2 years ago, maybe three, raising it to $100 now, $120, from $20. So we originally addressed it 2 years, raised it from $20 to $120. That's for the permit parking in the commuter lot.
Yes,
right. Is there an out-of-town fee? No, there is not. We don't allow. Certainly something worth considering. As for actual parking meters, I can't say that I had a discussion with any member of the governing body, but I would feel safe to say that the Chamber of Commerce, which is already experiencing a number of struggling businesses in town, would probably frown against parking meters being installed in our business and commercial district, obviously because it would be a deterrent to bring in business from outside of town.
Okay. Speaking of the Chamber of Commerce, I was hoping there would be a greater effort to try and make the item for the celebration of public events at least revenue neutral, so that any funds that's raised could be used to offset the expenses that are used to incur those fees.
Okay.
Okay. Another item I have.
I don't really have a response to that, but well, I mean, certainly we can take into consideration.
Okay. Another item I have is the revenue from, I guess, the code, uniform code.
Code enforcement.
Yes, the code enforcement. What is the borough's current policy on enforcing current codes that are in the books for individual homeowner improvements and whatnot?
The borough has always taken a very proactive approach in terms of code enforcement, whether it be brought to our attention by residents or whether it be actually having code enforcers present and providing with inspections.
May I suggest an approach that doesn't take too much time and is free?
Sure.
It's called Google Maps. If you turn on the satellite view, you get images, at least in Dumont, that are maybe 2 or 3 years old. So if you see an improvement that's on property, well, and if it's not on books, maybe that could be enforced. And
certainly,
no one has to, now you view it from anywhere, and then all you do is just go onto the property and inspection.
I think that's a great idea, and I would strongly encourage you to meet with Mr. Perkins so that you can hash out a policy so it could be adopted by the governing body.
Also, I noticed that the dollar amount that's spent on the telephone, is that a combination of landlines and cell phones, or?
I'm going to just.
Yeah, it's a combination.
Okay. For the number of lines, now maybe I'm mistaken, but $5,000 a month is seems sort of high, unless there are a lot of lines that are out.
I don't know how it breaks down to the number of lines, but I can tell you that it also includes the police department. They've got a number of Nextel lines, regular cell phone lines that they utilize, but we'll look into it. I know that number has dropped. We've also
second. I understand that the borough just bought a new PC server or a new file server.
That was last month?
Yes, you were here, John.
Right. Purchasing that kind of hardware affords one the ability to run something called voice over IP, which I'm sure you don't care about the technical details, but I can tell you the financial
The technical details are important, obviously, because of the need for assurance that we will be able to communicate in situations such as the 9/11 or, I mean, technology of, and the reliability of it is something that, you know, is a public safety issue, particularly for the police department, who need to do their jobs along with fire and EMS. So do you have any knowledge? Is it just as adequate, or if not better, or more reliable?
I can tell you certainly more adequate and more reliable in, when it comes to emergency, because the cellular network breaks down first.
Absolutely. Okay. So I'm just, and what happens if there is, for instance, is there a backup plan if there's a failure of internet service? I mean, for instance, we've all heard the story about the little old lady who cut the Afghan internet line and the country lost all of its internet connection. I mean, if the internet fails or collapses, or access to, explain it.
If the internet collapses, getting phone service will be the least of a problem.
Fair enough.
That's my opinion.
Fair enough. But I'm just saying, what happens is someone severs the tie to Borough Hall, and now next thing the police department can't have any access. Maybe you can provide some documentation on that so we can educate ourselves. I'm sure the governing body, you know, can't speak for them, but would love to educate themselves.
As I have provided written documentation in previous Borough Hall meetings, I get the impression that they're just ignored. But
I know Mr. Manor reads them with, you know, quite a lot of interest. I know that Mr. Casper does, and I know that Councilman Zimchansky do.
Okay, well,
and they brief me, and then they tell me to read it.
That's your option.
Just to add a bit of clarity there. I think it's well received and certainly processed and certainly amalgamated into our thought process.
Also, since the with the purchase of the server, I was a little bit, I guess, disappointed. Maybe I don't know the entire process, but certainly there wasn't too much seen to the public. There wasn't too much thoughts about looking at alternatives, because looking at the purpose of getting the server is used for file serving and mail serving. But on the other hand, there are other solutions that are available. Now I'm sure you've heard about cloud computing, which is a lofty and, you know, nebulous term, but
very useful.
But from an economic standpoint, bottom line is, you know, what you pay for the hardware alone, you can pay to get everybody connected, everybody served as far as email and storage is concerned. And the best thing is that you don't have to come in on the weekends to reboot the machine, because it's all held mobile redundant.
Right.
And I just thought that, you know, that should have been examined more before.
Well, one of the issues that we had, Mr. Chen, was that when we were advised the condition of our server, because of some numerous failures, our IT people came in and made a recommendation based on our needs. I will speak to them tomorrow. In fact, they were here today. I think they will be back tomorrow. I'll speak to them tomorrow and ask them about the IT issue and whether or not there would have been alternatives to the server that we got that was more adequate to help our needs. I can tell you, with regards to the police department, we just went through a major overhaul because of the redundancy that we need on our police lines for backup when there's failures.
Well, I mean, just right now, it's water under the bridge. Okay, but I just thought that maybe in the future, this
right. In the shop life, obviously, the servers, I mean, as we address long-term needs, one of my industries with the server was the need to take advantage of, obviously, having the flowing white paper on the server.
Again, it's just a suggestion.
Yeah, no,
it's your project.
Much appreciated.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I
will be the primary use of the night. Our second meeting originally is supposed to be scheduled for the 21st of June, but it happens to be high school graduation night. So we will convene at 6:30 on Thursday, June 23rd, 2 days later. At 6:30 in the executive chambers and at 7:15 in these council chambers. So please, if anyone you know wants to come, please share the information with them. It's on our website as well as posted up front on the board. And stay cool. Thank you very much. Can I motion to close?
Motion.
Second by Councilor Freeman. All in favor?